Hi guys, today's video is about no contact. Okay, so if you are in a no contact situation with your person right now, we'll see today what's his thoughts are, what his feelings are. I've tried to get more into his thoughts towards you and his current actions, what possibly it can be towards you. So right now we are all in lockdown, so yes, if you guys are not in contact with your person, we'll sneak peek into it and see what's going on. Okay, and for sure I'd like to say thank you guys for subscribing to my channel and for reaching out to me. If you have any questions, please drop it in the comments or you can message me on Instagram. Okay, and so these are your three cards. This is pile number one, this is pile number two, and this is pile number three. So as usual, just meditate on these cards and see which one connects with you the most. Okay, it says time for a love fest. What you give will come back. You'll find what you seek. I want you guys to really choose with your gut instinct. Okay, I know my viewers have a very good gut instinct, so please choose with your gut instinct and with your sixth sense and whichever calls to you the most. Okay, so if you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe my channel and we'll get started right away. Okay, so I'll start with pile number one. Hi pile number one, this is your message for your connection, we'll see it later. And this is your guidance from the angels, we'll see these two cards later. First let's see what's going on in your connection. This will be the overall energy of your connection. Okay, all right, so let's see what it is. The devil. Okay, so the devil card tells me that you guys may be in a relationship with somebody who is in a karmic situation, or maybe this person could have been your ex-husband, your ex-wife, or simply someone with whom you felt a very strong connection. Like karmic connection in essence is a connection where you feel very strong attraction towards them. Okay, because the karma wants to be fulfilled, that is why you feel very strong attraction, so that you go to that person and you fulfill that karma. So this can be a person with whom you have felt very strong emotional, physical, mental, whatever kind of attraction with. Okay, on for some other people, for another section of you guys, I feel like that the main issue here was that some people have gossiped about you. Okay, some people, some third party was there. Like I see a few group of people who spread rumors, who just ruined this connection, who spoiled this connection. There was a very bad element, bad energy, and this is not just coming from one person, this is coming from several people. Okay, several people wished ill for your connection, and this is why this connection might have made you go into no contact for this time being. Okay, so let's see what is his feelings right now that you are not in connection anymore. Your connection may have been paused, so let's see. I will see more into it. Okay, but let's see his feelings right now. This is his future action. Okay, his current feelings. Wow, all right, I see it. Wow, ace of swords. See guys, I feel like whatever these people have tried to tell your person, that you are not meant to be, or this person is not right for you, regarding you, they might have told them this, that you are not right for them, or they have told you that person is not right for you. You know, whatever gossips and lies these third party has told your person, your person is going to just see through them. You know, they are going to have this clarity. You know, they are going to have this clarity. They are definitely, this Ace of Swords tells me that your person is also very intelligent. Your person could be an air sign like Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Okay, I can see all signs here. He can be Gemini, Libra, Aquarius or Scorpio, Pisces, Cancer. Although among the water signs, Scorpio is felt mostly because of the Devil card and this card in reverse. He can also be Taurus, I feel like, okay. But air sign is the most prominent. He can be a Gemini, a Libra or an Aries, his sun or moon sign or rising. Or yours can be these three signs, Aries. Not Aries, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, okay. So I feel like what are his current feelings towards you? His current feelings towards you is that he wants to come back, okay. He feels regretful. Whatever happened, he had to move on from you. I see that he had to move on from you. And he is now just trying to come back towards you. I think he may have also taken the first step towards it. And you know what is the first step towards coming someone? It is to decide that in your head that you are going to come towards them. So I feel like they are right now in their strategic stage, you know, like in their thinking, what steps should I take to come to this person? So they have seen whatever these people, it may be a third party. I'm sorry guys if this is a scary image for you, okay. This is nothing to be scared of, this is just the energy, okay. I'm just going to put this mic. I don't know why I felt like some of you guys may be scared. So yeah, so I feel like this person, you know, he is these people, I mean, or it could be this person, it could be a single person who was orchestrating that. Maybe it was a third party, maybe it was a leader who was influencing a group of people. Or for some of you guys, I also feel like, you know, this person may have been under some kind of addiction, okay, which was very harmful, which was harming your connection. I'll get into that later. But I feel like whatever the issue was, this person is now gaining clarity. This person is seeing, okay, he is cutting through the bullshit with his sword, okay. And he is coming to realize, like, he's seeing, like, what happens, you know, when you just take some time off, you see the truth of a situation. And I think that is what happened with whatever no contact situation, whatever separation you guys have to go through. This gave this person some time to think and to understand exactly how things went wrong. He was able to put together the puzzles, and so now he's regretting moving on from you. He's regretting that he wants to come back, you know, but he is feeling like he's feeling very mournful, like he didn't want to move on from you and he had to because of this thing. And he now feels like he wants to move towards you, but the Queen of Pentacles is in reverse, you know. I'll just see a clarifier, I'll just clarify this card, you know, for your pile. Okay, Spirit, please tell me, why is the Queen of Pentacles in reverse? Oh my God. See, the Queen of Pentacles is clarified by the Ace of Cups. Yes. So, and you know what guys, the Nine of Cups is a wish fulfillment card, as you guys already know. So this card, with this card, they are in the Eight of Cups energy, which is reversed. And this, with this one card, they want to come back and have this one cup, you know. They want to have this one cup and fulfill their wish, which is to be with you, okay. Yes, because I feel like they see you as the Queen of Pentacles, okay. They see you like this, but they somehow feel like they did you wrong, okay. This is, I'm not getting this from the cards, I'm getting this intuitively, that they feel like they did you wrong and now they want to come full force with their emotions, okay. They want to offer you something emotionally. They want to come towards you and give you, tell you how they are feeling, tell you what they have missed for so many days. I feel like this overflowing emotions, okay. Ace of Cups is totally an emotional cup of love, and so I feel like whatever it is, it was between you guys, they are just cutting through the bullshit. So let's see what your relationship was like. Time for a love fest, as you have seen, time for a love fest, what does this card mean? It says actually everyone is reasonable. See, everyone is, he thinks that these people also had a reason, and they just have their own reasons. See, and usually it's worth trying to learn what they are to maximize chances of a full-blown 60s-style psychedelic love fest, which is always a good thing. So everyone is reasonable, okay? They just have their own reasons. These are the key two lines of this card, I feel. It's time for a love fest. It clearly says that this love fest, this cup of love is going to come for you. This offer is coming for you from this person. This is going to happen. And this love fest, this time for a love fest is going to begin very soon for you. I feel like that. And what this means is that everyone is reasonable. They just have their own reasons. You know, I feel like this third party or this whatever these people were or whatever this thing was, they influenced your person in some way. They told them something, or it could also be in-laws, I hear, for a certain group of people. The in-laws were filling their ears. It could be like that. And I feel like whatever they have told your person, this person is now understanding your perspective. They are seeing that whatever you did was for a certain reason. Okay, and for another section of you, I feel like this person may have got very abusive, not abusive, I won't use the word abusive, it's like they had got very dominating, very controlling, and I think you are the one who are realizing that it all happened because of some reason. They might have been going through something, and this is why it had to happen. You guys needed some time alone. You guys needed to separate for a while and then come back together. Okay, so I feel like definitely this love offer, they are going to come forward, and they are feeling very regretful. What they are feeling right now, they are feeling regretful. They are feeling bad about moving on. So what is your guidance from the angels? No, wait, postpone, say no. Okay guys, don't freak out. This is not a bad card, okay? The card says no, wait, postpone, pause, say no. So this is not a bad card at all. All right, this card just says that you guys right now is not the time for you guys to be together. This does not mean that it is not the right time in the future also. Right now you guys have been separated because of divine will. Okay, you guys have been separated because the divine ordained it. Okay, so this thing had to happen between you guys, but I feel like soon that time is going to come to an end, and you guys are going to come back, as this person is going to offer you something. Okay, so I hope you guys like this reading. If you want to know more, please suggest whatever you want to see down in the comments, and please subscribe my channel. Please press the bell icon. All right, let's move on to pile number 2. Hi pile number 2. Okay, so this is your reading. This is the overall message of your connection. We'll see it later. We'll see what it says in a detail. And this is your message from the angels, which will see what is the guidance regarding your situation. And now let's begin your reading. What is the situation with this person? This is your overall energy, okay? Wow. So this came in reverse, because I just, I did it like this. So it came in reverse. So it's the lovers in reverse, okay? The lovers in reverse indicates some sort of imbalance, okay? Some sort of imbalance. The lovers in reverse is about two people whose relationship was just going in the wrong direction. Means everything was correct between you two. You guys might have been good for each other also, but something just was becoming either very codependent or it was becoming very codependent is like, you know, like some people have asked me what is codependent. Codependent is like when you start to depend on the other person so much that you forget your own life, okay? Like you forget to practice your own hobbies, or you stop working on your own goals, and this harms you as a person. So that's what, when the angels intervene and they just separate you for a while so that you can grow and become fulfilled and independent individuals, okay? So I think that for some of you guys, this relationship was getting codependent, and for others I feel like there was some issue in your connection. There was some imbalance in the masculine and feminine energy in this connection. So let's see what is his future move towards you. Okay, devil, two of swords and two of pentacles. Yeah, so right off the bat I feel like for you guys that this person was very confused with all the twos. Can you guys see, we have two here, two people here, we have two of pentacles, we have two of swords, and again we have the two lovers. This is like, you know, this is very synchronous. Like just see, this is these two, the lovers card, if you have seen in the traditional Rider-Waite tarot, they are also like this, and this is also a lovers card. Yeah, so the message is very clear. The message is that, you know, your relationship has abruptly ended, or you guys are currently in separation. This does not mean that you guys will be in separation in future also. If you guys just heal this within yourselves, then you guys can come together faster, which I'll get into later. So what happened was, you guys, some sort of imbalance occurred, and this person was not able to decide, okay? This person was very confused. This person had to choose maybe between his work, his job and you, or he had to choose between some other third party and you, because I see the devil card and it signifies a karmic connection. So I feel like, you know, for some of you guys, it could be that this person was in a karmic connection. But what the thing that is very prominent over here is that he was so doubtful. And what is his present emotion? His present emotion is also, he's still undecided, guys. Oh guys, yes, see the moon. The moon also says it's partial, okay? And he's still confused regarding you in a way. Like, I don't know, he's unable to feel whether he should move forward, come forward towards you, or whether he should let things be for a while, because everything was so heightened, you know. With you guys, I feel like every emotion was very intense, every feeling, every argument was very intense, every fight was intense, and even the love was intense, even the feelings were intense, even the emotions were very heightened. So this person right now, that you are on a break, he is thinking, oh, should I again go to him, or should I just stay where I am? Because the good was so good, he's feeling like he wants to feel that goodness again. But then again he feels like, but what if we fight again? We were so fightsome, we used to quarrel so much. I feel like you guys used to quarrel so much, and yes, this is the energy I'm getting. So he's very confused, and he's just, I think he also wants to talk to you guys, okay? He wants to talk to you guys. He wants to have a very stable connection, stable communication. And I think that if until and unless you guys both are very stable, you guys won't be able to have that stable communication, where you're both very hot-headed. I feel like either you or your partner or both of you are a little bit hot-tempered, and so I feel like 2 can be an important number for you guys. It can be like 11 is an important number in your, it comes in your birthday, or that person's birthday, or is it was the day on which you guys met or proposed, or it's your anniversary, you know. So 11, 2 and 20, these kind of dates can be significant to you. And what is his future action? What is he planning towards you? Yes, I feel like, guys, the devil card has cleared that up. This person feels chained to you. The devil card, let me say this to many people have asked me why the devil card is so horrific. Okay guys, but I don't think it's horrific. No card in general is bad or good. The devil card over here is giving me a good vibe. It's telling me that you guys are chained to each other. See how these two are chained to each other? I feel like exactly in the same manner, you and your person have a karmic contract. You are chained to each other. Like, not chained in a bad way. Don't take it in a bad manner. It's like you have a karmic contract to fulfill. You have a soul contract to fulfill. So you guys will come together, okay? You guys are meant to come together. And this will happen in the future. Even though your person is confused, your person is very... your person is just going to and fro about it, but yes, I feel like this is coming from the divine. So let's see what this card has to say about your connection. What you give will come back. Yes, see, again, this is about karma, guys. This message is about karma. What you give will come back, and this is also a card of karma and about karmic relationships. So whatever you give in this relationship will come back. I was telling you now that you guys have a very intense connection. Like you guys fight very much or love very much, and it gets very intense. It is because of this, you know, because whatever you give into this connection, it's going to come back manifold. So you have to be very mindful of your words, your energy, your whatever you are giving to this person in terms of energy, in whether it's love, anger, or whatever it is, because it will come back, okay? And because this is a karmic connection, you have some sort of karma with this person, okay? You have some sort of karma, and this karma is not fulfilled yet. I get that too. This karma will be fulfilled in the future, and for that this person has to come back to you again. So what does this card say? When in doubt, give. Let them have it. Surrender. See, make peace, guys. When in doubt, give. Let them have it. Surrender. Make peace. When there's no doubt, give. Let them have it. Surrender. Make peace. See, life is so easy. The universe. So, this card says that you have to surrender, okay? You have to make peace with it, okay? You have to keep your peace, you know, at least one of you guys has to keep their peace, has to be calm, and so that this relationship can work. Let's see what the angels have to say. I don't read reversals with my wisdom oracle cards, okay? So, I'll take this in this upright manner. Initiation, rite of passage, crossing the threshold. Yes, again, see the snake over here. See the snake, and the snake is often depicted with the devil also. This card says that you know, the message from the angels is very clear. This is some sort of initiation for you. Like, what is an initiation? It's you are being asked to go into this path, into this karmic connection, and to fulfill this connection, okay? You have to go through this door and you have to cross it. Only when you are going through this dark and narrow road, you will be able to get to this good part. So you have to endure the bad in this connection before you are able to get to the good part. Maybe right now, when you are in no contact situation, you are feeling a little bit down, you are feeling a little bit bad. But you know what? You are going to fulfill this. You are going to walk this road, and you are going to find the light at the end of the tunnel. So all the best, guys. This was a very good reading. I hope you guys liked it. Please like, share, and please subscribe my channel, guys. If you like this reading, please subscribe my channel. Okay, I'll move on to pile number 3 now. Thank you. Hi pile number 3, this is your reading. So this is your overall connection. We'll see it later, okay? The energy of your connection. This is a message from the angels. We'll also see this later. So let's get into your reading and see what is going on in this connection. The Hermit in reverse. So I feel like, guys, this person is trying to find some guidance, okay? This person is currently trying to go and seek some sort of advice from someone regarding this connection. Why is that? Why are they seeking advice? Let's see your cards. Justice. The Six of Swords. Okay. Oh, wow. Amazing. So your cards are very positive. There's one major arcana here, the Justice card. Yeah, this is a very significant connection for you guys, okay? I feel like whoever has chosen this pile, the reason why this person is seeking advice currently is because he understands, he places a lot of value on your relationship. This was not a fling. This was not a relationship which this person took very lightly, okay? He felt like your connection was very important, and he gave you a lot of importance, and he, whether you know it or not, because I think most of you guys don't know it, this person had a lot of feelings for you, okay, had a lot of emotions, and he could not ignore you. So he felt like that you were very significant for this person, he or she. I usually just say he because I'm a girl, you know, so just take it as it resonates. I feel like what is this person emotionally feeling right now? I think this person wants justice for your connection. For some of you guys, I feel like this person may be going through some sort of legal battle. Maybe it could be related to his property or some work-related legal battle, or maybe he's getting divorced for some of you guys. Yeah, so some sort of justice related issues, legal related issues are going on. And for others of you guys, I very strongly feel like this person wants to make things right with you, you know. He wants to make things right. And why does he want to make things right? I'll tell you that. He sees you as his wish fulfillment, okay? This is, you know, I feel like this is his next action towards you, and he is moving towards you, okay? And the cards, as I drew it, made to signify his next actions towards you as well. Yes, so this was that card, and I think he sees you as his wish fulfillment, okay? So, yeah, so I feel like those of you guys... So I feel like, you know, what is his current emotions right now? He is moving towards you. He's just whatever reason he might not have taken action in the past, he's getting over it. Okay, so he's just getting over it, and he's coming towards you, and he's just crossing all these barriers. There are so many barriers, you know, which he's crossing, and he's coming towards you. This person can be an air sign, you know, Gemini or Libra, I feel strongly. He can also be an Aquarius, or he can be Pisces. This can be your sun signs or moon signs as well, okay? Pisces, Gemini, Libra. These can be your sun signs. Libra is strong here because it's a major arcana you are dealing with. But yeah, this person is, you know, currently wanting some sort of advice. And why he's wanting that advice is because he doesn't know how to come towards you. So if you guys have been feeling like this person has forgotten you, he has not. He cannot forget you. You are a major relationship in this person's life. He has not forgotten you. Instead, he is looking for some sort of advice from some, I think from some priest or some sort of guru, you know, or just some person whom he thinks is a wise person. He is going to for going to some sort of satsang, I want to say, or he's seeking some sort of wise counsel from some person, and he just wants to understand what this connection is and how to make things right with you. He really, really does want to do right by you. If he comes back this time, be sure that he is going to do right by you this time, no matter what happened in the past, because in this reading we are not seeing what happened with you guys in the past, but yeah, these are his energies. He wants to do right by you this time. So this is your overall connection. You will find what you seek. So let's read. If you've ever suddenly found and been loved by someone amazing, awesome, fun and fantastic, chances are astronomical you will again. See, chances are astronomical you will again, okay? You will be loved again by this person. So this person is assuring you that yes, if you even had a faintest doubt that this person did not love you in the past, know that this person loves you, and know that this person will again come back into your life. And you know, this card doesn't just come out like that. You know, this card, you will find what you seek. You will find the kind of relationship that you seek, and this is the card for your connection, for not for you, for both of you, okay? They will find what they seek. They will find this advice. They will find this wise counsel that they are seeking, and you know, you will find what you are seeking as well. And what this person is seeking is their wish fulfillment, and you are their wish fulfillment. For this card to come up right here, right at their next actions place, I think it's confirms it that they'll definitely find what they seek. And yes, they will make a move towards you very soon. I feel like, you know, they'll make a move towards you very soon. Let's see what the advice is from the angels. Align your life. See, what is not aligned or needs to change. Can you see the card? Yeah, I guess you guys can. So you guys need to understand what this thing is that is not aligned in your life currently, okay? And if there is something, I mean, alignment is like, you know, something which feels right to you. So if you are doing some, if you are in some profession which does not feel right to you, or if you are doing something regularly which does not feel right at the bottom of your heart, be very true to yourself. If you are true to yourself, you will feel that alignment from yourself, from within yourself, and then this person, it will, I think, somehow affect this person's actions as well, you know, because as we align things in our life, other people also get affected by it. So it has to start with you. I think whoever is watching this, this is a message for them. You need to start aligning your life with whatever it is your heart wishes, and get more and more and more into it, so that this thing, this person can come towards you sooner. They can find that light and be attracted towards you as well. Okay? So these are your cards. Please subscribe my channel and please leave a comment. Thank you guys for watching.